everyone. It's audible. So the topic, as it says, nosocomial infections, the hospital-acquired infections, commonly called as. So I would just run through what is HAI, what can DuPont do about it? I mean, how we can help partner or control the infections in the hospitals. So primarily, when we say, as the name suggests, the hospital-acquired infection, this is primarily due to viral pathogen or fungi, which a hospital environment, primarily promotes in an area. So when the patient arrives in the hospital, he's there to get healed, to get protected, but he's not knowing that unknowingly he'll be acquiring certain infections which he was not carrying to the hospital. And if he was carrying to the hospital some infections, he wasn't primarily planning that it would get spread to the other patients. And in these scenarios, because these become complex environments, there is no one single solution that we can say that can put a stop to the hospital-acquired infections, that tomorrow if we start doing this, it would be controlled, it would be zero. But there are ways and processes around it, and we will try to address some of those, how we can do that better. So how big is the issue? If we talk globally, the hospital-acquired infections, they range in the parameter of 7 to 12%. In Western countries, of course, because they are developed, they have seen through the processes, they are moving faster at a faster pace, they have been able to bring this down. So we can say from 0.8 to 8%. The USA, if we say, still the infection is like, for every 100 people discharged, 3 would carry the nosocomial infections or the hospital-acquired infections. In India, of course, this is just the reported data, but there would be unreported data as well, and the figures would be much higher. But we still say 10 to 30%, with 3% even in the best of the hospitals. So there is no zero. We can say that this hospital has a zero infection parameter. But these were just the numbers. If I have to address it in terms of bringing some matter to this subject, I think this would explain it in a much better way or in a much simpler way. We say 1 in 10 people die from these complications, which completely runs out to around 75,000 per year. The estimated, because of this infection, the stay of the hospital increases. The investment that people spend from their pockets ranges in this category, which is around $33 billion. Making it even more simpler, because I think the impact doesn't, people don't understand the impact, that this is numbers, probabilities, and stuff. This I liked from a slide which was shared by Dr. Manchanda, which says the healthcare-associated infections kill more people in a year than if every day a jumbo jet crashes, still the number would be less. So that is the gravity of the problem. That is what we want to address. And we would address it, collaboratively. There is no single intervention that can help do away with this problem. So there are three primarily sources. We say contact, airborne, and water. So primarily, because contact is when a patient comes to the hospital, he is in the hospital setting, he touches the surfaces, he interacts with the doctors, doctors touch them, attended by the nurses, stays on the equipments. This is how the infection carries away. Airborne, we can't control much. It goes away with the air, through the ACs, through everything, and the waterborne. All of these problems, if we say, they vary in their category and varies from hospital to hospital, infra to infra. The percentage may not be similar in each and every hospital. But what do we do about this? How do we prevent this? So there are, simpler ways saying it. We say we reduce contamination, we prevent transmission, and we influence behavior. Just touch base with it. This has been run by WHO very extensively, which says that even the right practice of hand wash can reduce the HAIs by almost like 50%. And I think now this at least the hand wash thing, I've been seeing doctors, patients, everybody is practicing in a very good way, even in India. So I think that that is one way towards it. What has been the primarily, I mean, why does HAI spread so much? Because the problem is that with the traditional materials, they allow the pathogens to grow, they provide a medium to these bacteria so that, you know, they can get food. If they don't provide any media to grow, they would get killed by themselves. So these materials have another problems. You know, they are very difficult to maintain. So primarily, even if you have installed something which is very good, but over a period of time, they start delaminating. So they start bringing the porosity into the, porosity factor into place, which kind of creates the problems or propagates the problems larger. They have a high replacement cost. So primarily, if there is a fissure in a granite, it has to be replaced, the entire countertop. You can't, say that, okay, granite is this, now it will remain there, and still the environment or the surface would be sterile. It will not be, because it will be deeper propagation of the pathogen. They have low flexibility, the traditional materials. I mean, you have to play with the ergonomics, but you can't play beyond a point, beyond the flexibility of the material. Even the designers struggle with when they, you know, have to choose between the materials. They plan to do it in the most functional, most aesthetic, and most ergonomical way, but with the limitations of the materials, they have to constrain themselves. Because I represent DuPont, I represent Korean, I think if there are architects in this room, we have heard Anandji and other people, they would have heard about this material. They would have used it in some of their projects. So I will talk, or I would stick my agenda to the surfacing solution, which is the Korean provides the surfacing solution. And how does it help in, you know, control or spread of the nosocomial or HAI infections? Before taking it further, I mean, I really like this video. And
being a teen with cancer, it sucked a lot. I missed homecoming and dances at school. I had to watch it on Facebook.
When designing the Angie Fowler Institute, we tasked architects for two critical things. One, to create a safe space. And the second was to create a space that was really uplifting, life-affirming, that would improve emotional and physical well-being for our young adults.
When you come in here, it was colorful and kind of a teen mood going on. It just made you feel happy when you work.
Teens, when they come into this space, are often in a place of emotional darkness. So we use the idea of light as a counterpoint.
The more ambient light that you can incorporate, the better the mood, the emotional well-being of the patients who are going through that space.
We never conceived of this space as a sterile clinical environment. We always thought of it as more of a boutique hotel. DuPont Corian became the backbone of the project. We're using it extensively throughout.
Corian is a remarkable material and is suitable for the healthcare environment. It is non-porous, and it doesn't promote the growth of bacteria. I think it has a calming and healing effect. When you use materials that allow light to pass through and to warm the environment.
I don't know that you could ever come to a place and be told you have a diagnosis of cancer and expect to have an uplifting experience. I think we've created an environment that permits that.
When I found out that I was cancer-free, like, are you crazy? Of course I went and I had to make a status on Facebook. Now that I'm a survivor, you can't stop me now.
So how do you feel? This is a happy ending, but in most cases it is not. So the problem is that what we can do for these kind of people, you know, who get admitted to these kind of I would say the deadliest diseases, because the problem is if they are in the sad environment, they remain sad. The body needs positivity, and if you can do it by adding materials or choosing the materials which can help healing, I think, and which are not only just the aesthetic point of view, but they're from the functional point of view. They don't allow those infections to propagate, so the healing would be much better. In fact, the gravity is that you are not only protecting the patients, you're also protecting the most important people in an hospital, which is the doctors themselves. So if the spread of the infection is controlled, it can even aid to, you know, your doctors to work there in the right manner. So what is Korean? I think I'll just give a brief around it. So it was invented by Dr. Slocum. He named it after his daughter, Carrie Annie, and the name, you know, how it starts from one phase and then it changes and evolves, it became Korean. So instead of Carrie Annie, it became Korean. That is how Korean name has evolved. The material itself is a solid surface which comprises 1/3 ATH, which is aluminum trihydride, and the 2/3 is ATH, 1/3 is PMMA, which is polymethyl methacrylate, and then there are pigments which are environmental friendly. We today in 2017 are celebrating almost 50th year of this product, and still I'm saying that we have been serious around using Korean in the healthcare applications very recently, which is almost like 4 years, 5 years, but it has been there in the projects for almost 50 years. Why it has taken so much time for the Indian sector to agree to it, I think they would want to see certain results or understand certain case studies before actually going for these kind of products. Why, I mean, with the traditional materials, why is it different? When you're using Korean, you are able to get the inconspicuous seams. That means you can plan larger panels without having to give the in-between joints, which become the source of infection. They don't have any VOC emissions. You can choose from a palette of colors. Globally, we have around 250. In India, we run around 100 colors. They're solid. You know, they're fire resistant. Certifying to Class B, Euro Class B. They have been approved by American Institute of Architects, I mean, recommended by them, that they can be used in the healthcare settings. So there are industry standards which we meet. It's durable, it's repairable. So tomorrow if there's a problem, of any kind of a crack or anything that is happening with this product, it can be very easily repaired in situ. So you don't need to change the entire thing. It's impact resistant to quite an extent. Absolute requirement in the healthcare is a stain resistance. So it is almost stain resistant to almost all these prominently used materials in the healthcare setting, be it X-ray, fluids, and be it betadines and other blood stains or anything. In fact, in an HIV situation also, it can be used and it can be again disinfected by using a common bleach solution. The industry standards that we meet, so it's a food grade approved, it's a green guard, it's a hygiene certified, which is LGA test certified, and it can also give you the LEED certifications if you are going for a green building design or something. The application areas that the Korean that you can think of, it's primarily, I would say, into each and everything, starting from the main reception areas, making them grand, making them welcoming, lobby areas, nurse stations, clinical and non-clinical areas, operation room cladding, and I can vouch it when we go further in this presentation that we have done quite good number of projects in India which have been running successful now. It can be used in the surgical scrubs, customized to the requirements, whether you want one bay, two bay, three bay, you can do that. Of course, the signboards, the corridor, the wall claddings, the furnitures. I'll just run through certain applications and you can view because of the thermoforming properties of this material. That means you can curve it and bend it into any shape. It can be even it's translucent in certain shades, so you can even backlit them, giving them the luminous effect in the hospital settings, which again is very positive. Nurse stations. Again, when we talk about the neonatal and pediatric areas, you can create stories by combining the colors. So this all, still it becomes easier to clean and maintain. So it can be used in these areas. Baby bath sinks and all, it is already being used. We talk about seamless wall claddings for the operation theaters. And this is what I was talking about. We have done, roughly around 40 to 50 operation room claddings in India. And we are also in discussion with a couple of more. So surgical scrubs, you can do this because these are very fluidic, easy to maintain and clean. You don't have any issues with the stains or anything. Can be used in the patient room settings, labs, the countertops, because the panel size is not a limitation. Cafeteria, because it's food grade approved, so even if the food touches this surface, there won't be any contamination. And that is why it is being used in most of the hospitality areas, the food counters, the F&B areas. The other areas could be, you know, as easy, like, you know, even for the trashes, wherein you put the disposables and all, because it's non-porous, it will not get contaminated. You can reuse it. So every time you don't need to, put in or get a newer one. It can be used in signages and all. The most important of all, we have these trusted partners who have used our product in various applications, ranging from the furnitures. For example, for the AIMS, we have done the critical care units. For the OR, CCU wall claddings, GTB Cancer Institute, we have done the vanities. Similarly, the Bird Hospital, we have done in Tirupati, a lot of OR room claddings. High-level Cancer Institute, we are doing the furniture claddings. So I'll run through. My apologies if I'm not naming any of them, but they are our trusted partners because they chose to do something different. And I would say definitely that the designers, they are the people who can design something which is functional, aesthetic, meeting the requirements of the hospitals. So with that, I would say thank you. It was short, crisp, brief. If there is anything that you would want to, ask me, or have a discussion with, it can be one-to-one. I am always, open to reverting on the queries and all. And I am also there for the whole day, so we can discuss this.
What is the life of this product?
So, sir, very laughingly, I mean, generally we say, because it has been 50 years, and our first installation was done the day it was invented. We have seen 50 years. Nothing has happened wrong with this material. Even this product is used in the exterior, in the facades. And we have projects which we have done in India for the facades. So primarily because of the weatherability also, there isn't anything which goes wrong with this material. So, as a benchmark, we have said that nobody has seen, lived through to see the life of this product. But since it has been only 50 years, we say another 50 years maybe. So let's see how it is. We haven't. Okay, if I say cost, I'll give an example this way because there are different materials in this. Yeah. So, sir, I'll explain it this way. We have done projects like Delhi International Airport where the column cladding has been done with this product. We have done Mumbai International project wherein, again, the column cladding has been done with this product. We have done similarly the Bangalore and similarly many hospitals, exterior facades. So, primarily the point is, how do you calculate that cost? If it is the total system cost over a period of time, we would always run better. If you're talking about the capex cost presently, yes, we are slightly expensive. But the point is that with these volume projects also being done with this product, it means that it is giving that value proposition. We can sit one-to-one and discuss that what is that cost that you're looking at. Again. Okay. Yeah. In fact, I forgot to touch base on that point. So DuPont in India has been almost like now 20 years. And over the last 10 years, we have started a facility called DuPont Knowledge and Training Center, which is in Hyderabad, which is a state-of-the-art facility, wherein we can train, we can show the possibilities of these materials. And we have trained the people whom we call as quality network partners, and they are across India, in major metros and tier two cities. So they are available there who can do this job in the right manner, as put in the DuPont fabrication manual. So there won't be any problem. We have, if you're using this product through a qualified person, he can give you a warranty, which is on behalf of, basically the company gives you, which is for 10 years. Warranty on the product. Yes.
Do you have a dealer network in Nagpur?
Yeah, we do have.
Okay.
What's the base material that this goes on to? Like, what do you have to?
The substrate should be, you know, anything which is like, it can be a wood, it can be a metal frame. Primarily, when we are doing the exterior things, because we need to use the mechanical fixtures which are not seen on the front, we go with the aluminum framing. We can go with the MS or the aluminum framing even on the wall claddings. And in certain cases where, you know, the moisture or any other concern is not there, we can even put it onto the plies or marine plies. Yeah.
Any further questions? Thank you.
Thank you.